Hello friends, in this session we will see some example problems how to find the transient matrix for a given system. Now up till we have seen there are the two equations in the state space analysis. Okay, one equation we have seen for a transient for state matrix, the x of t is a x of t, sorry, this is dash, x dash of t is plus b u of t. So this equation is called the dynamic equation. Okay, and in the previous session just we have while deriving this state transition matrix, we have seen we have used the equation a is a x of t. This is called linear homogeneous equation. So in the problems, the statement may be given for a dynamic system or a homogeneous system, linear homogeneous system, doesn't matter. The process is same to find the state transition matrix. So in this equation, the equation already given in the form of the second equation, that is called the linear homogeneous equations. Now from the statement, we have to find state transition matrix. With the previous session we have seen, we can define the state transition matrix is f of t is Laplace inverse of si minus a whole inverse. That is our aim, to find the f of t. So in the given system, it is x dot of t is a into x of t. So here the matrices A is given to us. So that's why we can say the matrices A is 0, 1, minus 2, minus 3. Okay. Now we will find the state transition matrix f of t equal to Laplace inverse of si minus a whole inverse. So first of all we will find what is si minus a. Okay, so si minus a is nothing but the multiplication of s into the state identity matrix. So just here we are multiplying. This is identity matrix, and if you multiply by s, so it's not going to change. So here we are going to the diagonal matrix s 0 0 1. So here si minus a, so this is si minus a, sorry, si, s into I, and this is minus a. So here we are getting si minus a is s minus 1, 2, minus 2, this is minus 2, minus minus become plus, and this is a s plus 3. So we are getting this s minus 1, 2, s plus 3. Now to find si minus a whole inverse, so that for that we have formula adjoint of s minus I si minus a divided by determinant of si minus a. Then first of all we will see how to find the adjoint of si minus a. So here we are finding this, you know, if we have matrix a b c d, then we can find adjoint of that is nothing but by changing the position of a and d. So this is nothing but d minus b minus c and a. So here by this way we can find the adjoint si. So that's why here this is s plus 3 will take the position of a, and a will take the position of b, so d, and here the sign will change. So this is minus 2 plus plus 2 to minus 2. Next we will find the denominator, determinant of si minus a. So determinant of si minus a is what is si minus a, this is s plus 3, this one, s plus 3, 1, minus 2, s. So this is nothing but we are taking multiplication, s plus 3 into s, s into s plus 3, s minus of minus this. So we are getting, by solving this we are getting s plus 2, s plus 1. And so s minus I, so we will say this is equation number 2. So equation number 2 becomes si minus a is adjoint divided by the determinant. So si minus a inverse is nothing but the adjoint divided by the determinant. So we have written this matrix in this form. Now our next step is to find the Laplace inverse of si minus a inverse. Okay, so that's why we'll take the Laplace transform of every elements of this matrix. So first element is s plus 3, s plus 2, s plus 1, this one. So we are taking by partial fraction you can write s plus 2 b plus b divided by s plus 1. By partial fraction, we are getting a equal to minus 1, b equal to 2. So in this equation, if you put the values of a and b, a is minus 1, b is plus 2. So here, we are getting, putting these values, and Laplace inverse is nothing but the first term. This term, 2 divided by s plus 1 is having the Laplace inverse is 2 e raised to power minus t. Minus 1 s plus 2 having the Laplace inverse is minus e raised to power minus 2 t. So this is the Laplace inverse of the first element. Similarly, for second element, 1 upon s plus 2 s plus 1. Similarly, 1 by s plus 1 s plus 2. By finding the partial fraction and Laplace inverse, we will get 2 e raised to power minus 2 t plus e raised to power minus 3 t. Similar for the third element, we are getting Laplace inverse. Similarly, fourth, and then we are taking f of t. You know, f of t. This is our transient state matrix. F of t. F of t is Laplace inverse of s I minus a. That is inverse. So here, the Laplace inverse we are taking the matrix form. So this matrix is called state transient matrix. So that is our aim, to find the state transient matrix. Friends, just previously I told you, whatever the system may be dynamic or homogeneous, the process is same. Only in this case, the matrices may be A is given, B is given, sometime output may be given, output Y equal to C of X of T. So matrices will be given. The only we need the matrices A. See, A is our requirement. So don't think about the other matrices and follow the same process. So to find the state transition matrix. So this is also very important. Personally, I am expecting some problems on the same topic, or maybe the derivation that we have seen, state model derivation for multiple input and multiple output. So this one, so these are very important. So let's hope you got it. And if you have any doubts, you can mail me, you can call me anytime, so that we can have a discussion on this. Thank you.